Alright guys, so just combing out this coyote here. It's a real nice coyote from my area. Actually, it's one of the better ones I've ever caught. It's for around here, that's a real pale coyote. You know, it's good white belly on it, and you know, it's big coyote. You know, from the base of the tail to the nose is 52 inches, so you know, pretty good coyote for around here. But anyway guys, going in here to, this is going to be the last week basically of our main trapping season. You know, there's beaver still goes on here for a little while, but you know, all landlines are pulled here this week. So basically here what this video covers is we're coming off a big cold snap here, and we're coming into basically our traditional January thaw. It always happens within a few weeks of each other, you know, and it's basically, we always get a big cold snap and then it warms up into like the 40s for a week or two, and it usually happens between the second week of January or the last week of January, you know, and it just so happened it happened here the last week of trapping season. So the coons are rutting right now, and basically what this week's going to cover is we're going to show you here, I'm going to show you a fox that I caught. This would be on Saturday, and whenever we still had our cold temperatures and it started warming up after that, and during that weekend there we had one of our 19 shotgun seasons we seem to have here in Illinois. So you know, it kind of limits where I could set, but anyway, then the week ahead started to seem to, it was going to warm up. And so basically, this video is, I had everything pulled for the most part on Sunday, getting ready for this week. I started setting Monday, and so basically all these catches are from Tuesday through that following Sunday, and that's whenever our season ended. So you know, we had, you know, 5 good checks for the most part, you know, on a lot of this stuff, but anyway, mainly targeted coons. It was a run and gun technique. I was just trying to slam out the best few days I could, you know, concentrating on the quick sets. Like I said, the coons are rutting, so we're basically just intercepting them in trails. You know, picked up a few other critters, you know, along the way. In this video here, caught 2 bobcats this week, so the catch of those and the release. Because we can't keep them. So the release is also in this video. So I took the camera a lot this week. I tried to get as many catches as I could on video for you guys. I know everybody likes to see catches. So anyway, here's the last 6 days of trapping for 2014-2015 for me. So hope you guys enjoy. Alright guys, it's good and cold here. But still catching a little bit of fur here. Got this nice red fox here. This was a scent post set for coyote or fox here. Caught them both here, so real nice, pretty cherry fox there. Looks real good. We'll get him taken out of the trap here. All right guys, well, it's still real cold. It's the next day actually here. We had some rain come in, actually quite a bit of rain, but brought some good cold temperatures with it. But you can see this is the that's the same set there that I caught the red fox in. And so you know, we had all that rain, you can see my poor truck. But anyway, that's just the power of that wax dirt, you know. It rained literally all afternoon yesterday and then all last night and quit early this morning, and you know, that coon still got in there with that wax dirt. So we'll get this guy taken out and move on. Alright guys, so I get a lot of questions about remakes, you know, and of course, you know, you catch a lot of critters on remakes. You know, I caught the red fox here yesterday, it rained, and then, you know, we had, you know, this coon in here today, so, you know, no problem catching critters in remakes. So, anyway, what we got here is,
You can see with our rain, it's a muddy mess. Trap bed's full of water, everything else. So this was just a set post set. What we're gonna do is I'm just gonna leave this trap unset. It's freezing right now. It's about 20, 26, 27 degrees. It's gonna get down into single digits tonight. So all this water from this rain will be froze. That ground will be froze again. And then tomorrow, whenever I come back and check, I've got another set just off to the side here. You know, of course, setting doubles. And so I still got this area working, but I'll just come in and just chisel out a new trap bed and simply reset that trap. We've had so much rain here this year. In some instances, if it's so bad, you know, like I might move the trap just, you know, 8-10 feet over there, you know, or something. But you know, always set your catch circles. You know, you can miss a lot of critters doing that. You know, you've got a lot of eye appeal, a lot of scent. So you know, just because you make a catch, don't pull that trap. All right, guys, checking sets this morning. It's a nice, cool, crisp morning. Sun's just coming up. Got this coon here. I don't know what kind of a situation he got himself in. He's like hanging up on that branch. It's kind of cool looking. Nice boar coon. We'll get him taken care of and we're moving on. All right, picked up this nice big skunk. This big skunk had a scent post type set there using that stump. Got Mr. Skunk. All right guys, so running trap line today. Sun's just coming up. Got us another nice gray fox. This one here's got some real nice color to him. Real good looking animal. So we'll get him taken care of there, and we're moving on. Hopefully it's a good sign. We're about six sets into the day, so it's a good deal. Well guys, can't forget about Mr. Possum. Bread and butter of a trap line. All right guys, so got the first coon of the day here. Nice boar, rut's going on, they're running. But anyway, right here next to this real sandy creek, and good sun, of course, but couldn't get a pogo in the ground. It's just like quicksand around here. So anyway, just a little tip, inch and a half or a 2-inch fence staple right inside that tree. It's easier than having to screw with cable extensions and stuff if you're anchoring your traps all the time. Put that fence staple through your cable, it'll hold any coon out there. So get this guy taken care of, and moving on. All right, there's another nice big mud ball for you. So, we're catching them. All right, so here's another coon. Got him in a 1.5. This was just a dirt hole set. He's got it all tore up, but a dirt hole set with a 1.5. Good catch on a big boar coon. Can take care of. Moving on. All right, so there's another nice boar coon. Like I said, guys, this is the rut. This is the time to be out here. This is our January thaw. You can see the creeks are starting to thaw, starting to run a little bit. It happens every year within about a 2-week period usually, and got to make hay while you can. So get out there, catch them. Another boar we can take care of, moving on. All right guys, checking today. You can see the game trail. Another nice coon. We can take care of, moving on. All right, here's another nice coon right on a trail going across the four-wheeler trail. So, good deal. All right, guys. So, real quick here, just wanted to talk about what I'm doing this week. This is the last week of season. Just running and gunning. It's our traditional kind of a January warm-up deal where, you know, we get a week or two of warm weather, and it always happens. And you got to get going, and you got to get going quick. So, anyway, basically what I'm doing this week is I'm trying to get a bunch of sets out in a bunch of locations. And the coons are rutting. They're not really going for their food sources. You know, so they're running trails, is essentially what it is. And the whole point of catching these coons with bait is you just got to stick it right in front of their faces, and they will eat it. But anyway, so this is a typical set here, like what I said. Everything's real easy to get to for the most part. It's a time thing. But you can see this piece of timber back here. It's a piece of log timber. It's 80 acres, and it's got like a 60-acre field around it. And this is a lot of what I'm setting. You can see just the main trail right there. And instead of going into that timber and spending a bunch of time trying to pick out all that, I'm just going around this whole piece of timber just setting up trails with dog proofs or dirt holes, you know, on 1.5s. And then I'll throw in a few canine sets. But it's a run and gun kind of technique here. And you can see here with this guy, nice big boar coon, it produces. And I'm not traipsing through that woods, you know, killing half my time, you know, running around. I'm just going in, getting the animals real quick, and then moving out. Because like I said, this last week, this area here will only have 4 checks on it for season ends. So that's just kind of what I'm doing. I know I'll get a bunch of questions about it. So anyway, that's kind of the technique that I'm hitting here right at the end for the rutting coons. All right, guys. Got another nice big boar coon here. This is the, I caught a coon in this set yesterday too. So for those who say, you know, you can't catch doubles on coons in the same set, well, I catch a lot of them. But anyway, nice big prime boar coon. We'll get him taken out of and we're moving on. All right, so we got this real beautiful skunk here. Got just perfect striping on him. Pretty good size too, so that's a good deal. All right, so here's another coon. Little small game trail coming down through that little batch of bush there. Produce a coon. All right. All right, guys, another coon here. This is just a tile drain. Little trail coming up, got the coon. All right, so the creeks are finally starting to thaw out good. And this one here, you can see it's cut like 4-foot high sides, bunch of little sandbars and whatnot. And nice big old, this nice dark color coon. He's gonna be real dark once I get him washed up. But another nice coon, keeping at him. All right, so got a dirt hole set right there, 1.5. And we got a nice coon, real nice coon. So we'll get this guy out of here and we'll move on. All right, so got another coon here. This is that tile drain one. We had a coon in here yesterday, so it's a good deal. Get this coon taken care of, moving on. All right, guys, so I was stressing setting doubles. This is why. We've got a couple of coons there with some bracelets on them. But you know, you're missing these coons if you're setting singles, you know. But it's a good deal. Get these guys out and we'll move on. All right, so checking today here again. This is the same set that had to put a fence staple in because we couldn't get anything to hold. And we've got another nice big boar coon. This is the third coon in 4 checks off of this set. So real nice coon. We'll get this guy out of here and we'll move on. All right, okay, so setting the high bank of this creek here, you can see the game trail. They're not going down in the creek, they're walking the high bank. We've got this giant boar coon here. This is it's a 4X coon for sure. Nice big coon. Set a trail. There was a set right there. Caught a coon in 2 days ago. So set trails. This is a dog proof. The other set there is a 1.5 on a dirt hole. So, you know, depending on which way they come from, they can get both, they can choose whatever. But big old coon, we'll get him out of here. All right, guys, so we're in this little pond here. It's an acre and a half or so, not very big, but you can see here, this is just a little push up here these muskrats got. I mean, it's real small, not even the size of a 5-gallon bucket, but whenever the ice was on, you could see air bubbles. So I knew there was a couple muskrats in here. And you can see that trail just there where they've been coming in and out. And I just stuck a conibear there. Got Mr. Muskrat here. Not a very big one, but nice muskrat. So we'll get this guy out of here, reset this trap, and move on. All right, so got us a big deep timber coon here. It's just, we're in nothing but just a big piece of timber here. Real big ridges and just setting the bottoms of every ridges. Hoping something will come through, and this guy here did, so it's a good deal. Bummer. All right, so here's another nice coon. You can see it's just on this arch on the inside turn of a creek. They had a trail coming down through it, so it's dog proof, and there's coon. All right, so here's another coon. Once again, simply just setting game trails in tall grass. Produces nice big boar coon. There we have it. All right, guys. Checking the line today. This is the second to last day here of the season, and we've got another bobcat. Real nice critter. We still can't keep him. The governor vetoed the bill his last day in office, so we'll have to let this guy go. But they're quite prevalent around here, as you can see. But real nice bobcat, real nice critter. We'll get this guy released and out of the trap, and we'll move on. All right, guys, so we got this bobcat here, and I've got the helper here, so he's gonna video, and we're gonna try to show you a good release here. This bobcat's caught by the back foot. We've got our little catch pole here. We're gonna get around his neck and trap off as quick as we can.
Just gonna come in here real easy. He's gonna thrash around a little bit. No big deal. We'll get him pinned down. Take the trap out. And then we'll just release this guy.
Nothing to it, guys. Nothing to it. All right. We got this nice boar coon here. Set right on a trail. Dog proof on a trail. Produces a coon. All right, here we have another nice boar coon. This is just a trail. You can see the trail there goes into the woods, into a picked bean field. It's not really a food thing, but these coons are running from den tree to den tree, so we're just intercepting them. All right, setting the edge of this creek bank here. The coons are running up and down it, and picked up a nice mud ball here. All right, guys, so this is pull day. We're pulling sets today, end of season, getting down to about our last 10 traps or so, and we've picked up another bobcat. This is the second one in 2 days. Had one yesterday, got this one today. This one here's a little small guy. You can tell they're breeding pretty good. This one here, he's got a good pad catch there, and this is a 1.5 double jaw. This is actually a trail set for a coon at a dirt hole, and it got our nice bobcat. So that's cool. We'll get this guy released and out of here, and hopefully next year we'll have a season for him. Be able to keep him. All right, so we're gonna try to release this bobcat again. Got a back foot catch on a 1.5. Do it real quick. This cat's got real nice spots on it. Release him here. Okay.
Sometimes I don't realize they're out of the trap. There he goes.
All right, got another coon here in a creek. They're running this creek for a ways and then coming back up on dry ground, setting the creek to pinch point. Nice coon again. All right, we got another nice coon here. Once again, setting just trails going through the grass. Another nice coon. We'll get them out of here. All right, so the coons are coming out of the field, crossing this creek and going up and across. So got us a set there. Produced a nice coon. Muddy coon. All right, guys. So this is potentially the last coon of the season here. Getting down and pulling traps. Today, this is the last day and getting down towards the end. Another nice coon set on trail. We'll get this guy out of here and move on.
All right, guys. So that was the last week for the most part. That was basically the end of the land trapping for 2014-2015. As I said, it was a run and gun kind of technique. You know, I primarily set 1.5s on dirt holes and dog proofs. It was quick, in and out. I was mainly targeting coons, you know, picked up a few other critters, of course, you know, along the way. But you know, that's our January thaw. You know, it's going to get cold here again. They're calling for negative temperatures all next week. So it's just one of the things that happens every year. You got to kind of get it while you can. And anyway, that's, you know, that's usually how our season comes to a close here for the most part. So, you know, all in all, not a bad season. Our coon numbers were down. They were definitely down. If you look at all my coons, we're actually missing a year class of coons, which, you know, our coons here, they seem to swing on 4 or 5 year cycles, and which should make next year or the year after, you know, a good year. So caught a lot of boars this year, a lot more than normal. Usually I'm about 50-50, a lot of boars. So anyway, like I said, not a bad year. We still got beaver season left for a little while, and then we've got, for the next 15 days, we've got this extended muskrat and mink season, and it's, you can only use conibears and they have to be completely submerged, so it's not like you can go out there and just hit them hard, but you know, I'm gonna stay with it for a little while. So anyway, guys, definitely not the end of my season yet, but anyway, I figured I'd just share with you here, for the most part, what the end of the landline looks. What's on the rack there, those four rows, that's this week. That's what you guys seen in the video. We've got a row of canines there. There's several in there there's several that's not there. I've already got rid of those. We got a big old bunch of possums up there, big old rack of skunks. Coons, bunch of muskrats, more coons, and then like 25 beaver there. So anyway, guys, that's about the majority of my land season. Like I said, it's still doing a little beaver trapping, a little muskrat trapping. Videos aren't done for sure. I've got a ton of videos here we're gonna put up here on different things. But anyway, like I said, we've still got a little beaver and muskrat season, so we're not completely done yet. Here's what I caught today. I got there's 5 big muskrats there, and then 5 beavers. So you know, y'all never seen a 50-pound beaver. And that dude right there, I weighed him. That's what they look like. And getting these big muskrats here. Them dudes weigh about 4.5 pounds a piece. So anyway, guys, you know, that's that. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, I took the camera a lot more than normal. Just tried to get you, you know, pretty much the last week. I appreciate all the support there through this season. Like I said, we've got, of course, some beaver. I'm making a video right now on that, and you know, some other things. So, but anyway, I hope everybody else had a good season, and can't wait till next year. So we'll talk to you later, guys.